I'm Dr. Rene Schroat-Lewis.
And I'm Dr. Laura Ruhl. And we're both associate professors in the Department of Earth Sciences at the University of Arkansas, Little Rock.
Every 2 years, we get the opportunity to teach a course called the Geology and Ecology of the Bahamas.
We go to San Salvador Island, where we really get to see modern-day processes that have formed, and some really cool geologic processes that took place millions of years ago are happening today in Bahamas. We met weekly for 8 weeks before the trip. Everything we discussed throughout the semester and they learned about, we got to see on this trip on San Salvador.
And it's at that point that it actually makes sense. So learning about how the unique sediment forms there and actually being in the surf while it's forming makes for a whole different experience.
The swim at the end of the day, like wherever we were snorkeling, that is what made it all worth it, because you got to just go in the reefs or wherever water thing we were doing.
There was a lot of fun after class. I mean, everybody here is friends. We all got along very well, so anything we could do together, we did.
As instructors, we have to drive, and that is one of the things I miss the most. Sitting in the back, just getting the wind in your hair. It's just so nice to be in the back.
We made a lot of fun memories doing that.
This was Pigeon Creek, which is an estuary type of environment where it's very low energy, so a lot of mud accumulates, and it's kind of fun to walk through because it's kind of cold and soft on your feet.
My favorite thing was when we snorkeled down Pigeon Creek and we all got out there and took our snorkel stuff off and just walked around, and it was so nice. It was so pretty.
Oh, there's a starfish!
Graham's Harbor, it's also filled with abundant starfish.
I really liked the seagrass and the estuaries because it felt like I was flying a little bit, like going in through the trees and like spying on the fish. It was fun.
My favorite part of the trip is like facing so many of like my fears. It's very terrifying snorkeling when you haven't like swam in years, and swimming in Lighthouse Cave was amazing. You know, I was terrified the entire time, but it was so fun. The part where we turned off all of our lights and it was just complete total darkness, that was amazing because I've never been in a place so dark, and it was really cool because I've never done something like that before. And you know, like when I was growing up, I would watch like people on like National Geographic doing stuff like this, and like now I'm getting to do it.
Lighthouse Cave is probably my favorite. I mean, come on, we got to swim through a cave. It's as cool as it gets.
My favorite things were going up in the lighthouse.
So every spot that we go to on the island, there's something interesting and unique about it, and we share why we take the time to go to that spot on the island, because biology plays such a huge role in this unique environment.
I was like, you know what? I don't know how to swim, but for this class, I'm going to freaking learn. And I had a lot of people in this class helping me along the way because it was definitely very hard. The waves were crashing in your face at all times. It was definitely worth it. I would highly recommend it.
My favorite thing was snorkeling along all the reefs and seeing all of the different fish. I've never seen such colorful fish in my life, and seeing them, it was really fascinating.
I wanted to come on this class because I wanted to see the coral, because I mean, you hear people talk about how they're dying, but to like see it in real time was pretty sad. So just seeing the preventions that they are trying to do with like to help the coral stay alive despite the bleaching and the rising temperatures of climate change was just really impressive.
On this island, the modern day processes that are going on in the coral reef, we can then later go and see in the rock fossils. We have huge fossilized coral reefs out there that are amazing to see and world-renowned on this island.
I would recommend this to anyone who wants to be challenged but also to see some really cool things.
During our scavenger hunt on Trash Beach, they find all sorts of weird items.
We've found messages in a bottle on this part of the beach.
And even this year, they took home a soccer ball.
It was the best spring break I've ever had in all my years of being in school, and I would do anything to go back.
You better bring your sunglasses and your sunscreen and your long pants and your long t-shirt, because the equator sun is not a joke and it will burn you and you will look like a KFC nugget.
I had never swam before in my life, so I actually had to take swim lessons to take this course, and just having this supportive group helped me to go all the way to the wall. And seeing sharks right below me and stingrays was freaking crazy.
Looking back, I love that I was being chased by a barracuda. That is one of the most exhilarating experiences of my life.
Going to the wall, that was really freaking cool to actually get to see sharks and stingrays and stuff out in the wild. Also just intimidating with how steep of a drop it had.
The wall is the spot on the island where you're swimming in 50 feet of water, and then suddenly there's no ocean floor below you. It's gone.
It's only dark water beneath you at that point, and it drops to about 12,000 feet deep.
And the students know this before they go out swimming there, and that can be really intimidating. But every one of them did it. They all swam out to the wall.
It's also really cool because you realize how small you actually are in this world. You know, the ground is 50 feet below you, and I was like, I could just float away out here, and I'm just the tiny piece of this world. Like, it's so big, and I'm just in the ocean all by myself. Like, you're always told the world does not revolve around you, but you never actually can realize how big the world is.
How many days until March 17th, 2024?
It's 691 days until then.
Laura and I are already counting down the days until we get to go back again.
Come join us in the Bahamas!
It was such an incredible adventure.